Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and I'm going to talk to you today about the three most important files in your Python project. These include a Makefile, a Dockerfile, and a requirements.txt file. Let's go ahead and get started. Let's take a look at the three files here that are important. First up, we have a Makefile. A Makefile is critical because it allows you to automate things like an installation step, a lint step, a deployment step. And really, it's like a set of recipes. You don't want to have to go through and look at every single ingredient when you're cooking at home. Likewise, you want to use a Makefile so you don't have to look things up over and over again. So really, it's a simplification process. Next up, we got Dockerfile. Dockerfile is critical because it attaches the runtime. 2022 and beyond, there's no way projects are not going to use Dockerfiles. It's really a must-have. This runtime packaging is critical. Make sure you have it in your project so you can containerize and deploy containers. Next up, we have a requirements.txt file. This is where you would hold the Python package requirements. Critical because it allows you to pin the version number. So this means that someone that checks out your project 4 years from now, they're not going to go through and guess what version of a package you were thinking about, and it really does automate things, and you can use the freeze command for that. Let's take a look at this project, Noah Gift FastAPI. It's got those three components that I mentioned, the three most important files in your project. It's got a Makefile. We go here. What does it do? Well, we have an installation step that's wrapped up. Makes it easy. I just need to do make install. If I do a make test, it tests my code. If I do a format, make format, it does my formatting for my code. So really, it automates all these really complex steps, and I don't have to remember these. Next up, if we go and we look at the most important other file, is requirements file here. Notice here that I've got the packages, and if I wanted to pin these, when I'm in rapid development, I wouldn't necessarily pin them, but once I want to go and put these into production, I would go through and I would pin these project files. The other thing that I would do is look at this Docker file. So you can see here that I deployed this to Amazon. And what I did is I said from the public.ecr.aws lambda python 3.8 Docker base image. And this allows me to pull in just what I need in order to deploy it to that environment. I do a bunch of commands here to set up the runtime, and then I've got this thing going. And you can see from this picture that all I need to do is say Docker build space dot. Now I've got the thing running, and I can say Docker run. And you can push this into either a source code repository or a container repository in Amazon. So really, these are the three most important things: Dockerfile, Makefile, and a requirements file. All Python projects can have it. And further, if I go and I want to set this up for continuous integration, it's very trivial to do that.